And sisters, we offer this holy sacrifice of the Mass for the eternal rest of Robert Levanite. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe
eleison.
Kyrie
eleison. Let us pray. O God, who delight in innocence and restore it, direct the hearts of your servants to yourself, that caught up in the fire of your Spirit, we may be found steadfast in faith and effective in works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed is the man who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord. He is like a barren bush in the desert that enjoys no season, no change of season, but stands in a lava waste, a salt and empty earth. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside the waters that stretches out its roots to the stream. It fears not the heat when it comes. Its leaves stay green. In the year of drought, it shows no distress, but still bears fruit. More torturous than all else is the human heart. Beyond remedy, who can understand it? I, the Lord, alone probe the mind and test the heart, to reward everyone according to his ways, according to the merit of his deeds. The word of the Lord. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Blessed
are they who hope in the Lord. Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does prospers. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Blessed are they who have kept the word with generous heart, and yield a harvest through perseverance.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
The Lord be with you. And with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, "There was a rich man who dressed in purple garments and fine linen, and dined sumptuously each day. And lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who would gladly have eaten his fill of the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even used to come and lick his sores. When the poor man died, he was carried away by angels to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. And from the netherworld, where he was in torment, he raised his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. And he cried out, 'Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am suffering torment in these flames.' Abraham replied, 'My child, remember that you received what was good during your lifetime, while Lazarus likewise received what was bad. But now he's comforted here, whereas you are tormented. Moreover, between us and you, a great chasm is established to prevent anyone from crossing who might wish to go from our side to yours, or from your side to ours.' He said, 'Then I beg you, Father, send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that he may warn them, lest they too come to this place of torment.' But Abraham replied, 'They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.' He said, 'Oh no, Father Abraham, but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent.' Then Abraham said, 'If they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded if someone should rise from the dead.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Today's Gospel and the first reading remind us that our deeds, whether they're good or bad, have eternal consequences. Notice what we heard in the first reading. "I, the Lord, alone probe the mind and test the heart to reward everyone according to his ways, according to the merit of his deeds." These readings are reminding us that there is eternal life and there is a reward for those who have done evil and those who have remained faithful to the Lord, to his commandments. Especially there are eternal consequences due to sin of omission. Notice that man who was rich went to hell tormented in flames because there was someone in need right next to him and he did nothing to help that person. He didn't went to hell because he was rich. No, he went to hell because he ignored the needs of his neighbor, especially that person who was suffering, who was eating the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. When we turn our backs on those who suffer, knowing that we can do something for them, we're committing a sin of omission. And remember that there is another parable in which we see that those who went to hell were those who didn't visit the imprisoned, who didn't feed the hungry, who didn't give a drink to the thirst, those who failed to do good were those who went to hell. And remember that at the very beginning of the Mass, one of the penitential formulas we use to ask for forgiveness and so prepare ourselves to celebrate worthily the sacred mysteries is that we say that we have failed to do good. Forgive me, Lord, because I have failed to do good. So we are confessing publicly that we have committed sins of omission. But we only focus on what is evil and forget that whenever we fail to do good, that is also evil. And it is also accountable to be punished with the flames of hell. Yes, it is possible to be condemned. It is possible. And in the Spanish translation, because in English, when you say you, depending on the context, it might be a singular pronoun or a plural pronoun. In Spanish, we distinguish. We use a specific pronoun for the singular and a specific pronoun for the plural. And in the Spanish translation, when Abraham is talking to Lazarus, he says, moreover, between us and you, that you is in plural. Is in plural. He's not talking to one person, but several persons. So there are people in hell. People. We don't know who, how many, but there are people in hell. And this is not a message that most of the people in this age like to hear, because they don't want to repent. They don't want their conscience to bother them. And notice that that rich man who is suffering those great torments, he asks Abraham, send Lazarus to the earth because there I have five brothers, that he may warn them. And he says, Abraham says to him, let them listen to Moses and the prophets. It is like if he would say, let them listen to the church. Let them listen to the shepherds of the church. There they have the catechism. They have the word of God. There they have the right interpretation of the word of God. Let them listen. But what is his answer? They will not listen. They're stubborn. They don't want a change of life. But if there is someone coming from the dead, then they will listen. But the answer of Abraham is great. You know, it's if they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, if they would not listen to the church, the commandments, the word of God, the right interpretation of the word of God, neither will they be persuaded if someone should rise from the dead. When I see, for example, people doubting the real presence of Christ in the Eucharist, because here in the United States it's a tragedy. It is tragic that more than the half of the Catholic population in the U.S. do not believe in the real presence of Christ. It is tragic. The core of our faith is the resurrection of Christ and the real presence of Christ in the Blessed Eucharist. When I see people that they do not believe, and we have plenty proofs around the world of Eucharistic miracles, of breads becoming real flesh, of consecrated wine becoming real blood, and in the face of that, they would not convert, they would not repent. Well, it is not a problem of the church. It is not a problem of the teachings of the church. It is not a problem of the sacraments, it is a problem of faith. A personal response to God's grace, that is the problem. But then, in the first reading, the prophet Jeremiah, speaking in God's name, says something important to us. He says, "Cursed is the man who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord." Because if our hearts are turned away from the Lord, and we seek our strength in our human flesh, which is weak, pierced by sin, we will never have the strength to persevering in doing good works. Because our flesh is weak. And then he describes the human heart. Notice this. "More churches than all else is the human heart, beyond remedy. Who can understand it?" We need God's healing power. We need God to make our heart straight. Otherwise, if we have a crooked heart, we won't be able to love and fulfill his commandments. That's why we need prayer, the sacraments, the teachings of the church, because, you know, our hearts is many times torturous and crooked because we don't have a well-formed conscience. So let us listen to the church. Let us listen to the prophets of our times. Let us listen to the law of the Lord represented in the figure of Moses. Let us instruct ourselves in God's will, in God's paths, so we may inherit the eternal reward and partake in Christ's kinship in heaven. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the church, the world, and for one another. Your response to each intercession is your prayer in silence. During this Lent, we're going to try to make more silence as we celebrate the Eucharist. For our Holy Father, our bishops and priests, that they may faithfully hold up the law and the prophets, which point the way of salvation to all who choose to hear. For world leaders, that they may not seek their strength in human beings, but trust in the Lord and flourish like a tree beside the running waters of life, justice, and peace. Let us not stop praying for their conversion of their hearts to the Lord. For those who are dried up in spirit through neglect of God and his life-giving way, that the Lord who alone probes the heart will attract them in secret ways back to himself and to the sacraments. For the poor and neglected suffering ones of our own day, that they may have eyes to see them and compassion for their wounds. We pray especially for the most vulnerable. We pray for the lonely, the sick of our parish community, mothers who are struggling for the end of abortion. For our beloved dead, especially for Robert Levinite, that their purification may be shortened through our loving prayer, and that they may soon find a place with Lazarus in the bosom of Abraham. God of heaven and earth, listen graciously to the prayers that we present to you. Have mercy on us and forgive us our sins. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, for the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, for the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor by this present sacrifice, we pray, O Lord, sanctify our observance, that what Lenten discipline outwardly declares, it may inwardly bring about through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that, freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have all those worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord. Let us pray. May this sacrifice, O God, remain active in its effects and work ever more strongly within us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Here I have the relic of Saint Casimir. Today we actually celebrate his feast day. He's the patron of Poland and Lithuania. I think that's how it's pronounced, Lithuania, okay? And he's a great saint, a great king. He was a king in Poland, and he would spend hours during the night before the Blessed Sacrament. And when 100-ish years after he was buried, when they opened his grave, his body was incorrupt. So kings can be saints. Politicians can be saints. They just have to listen to God, right? Okay. The Lord be with you. Abide with your servants, O Lord, who implore the help of your grace, that they may receive from you the support and guidance of your protection through Christ our Lord. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Casimir,